Hi, I'm Paul Kinlan. I'm a developer advocate at Google. I work on Chrome and I've kind of briefly worked on the Web Lab project. I'm here with two of the engineers behind Web Lab as well, Roger and Matthias. Do you want to give yourself a bit of an introduction?
I'm Roger. I'm a creative technologist at BeReal, and I've been the technical lead of the project.
And I'm Matthias. I am also a technical creative. Do you say that?
Yeah. It's
I'd be
either
real.
a
Why not?
creative technical or a technical creative.
Yeah. Don't know the difference.
Playing The Simpsons, I'm an instrument technician, not a oh, it doesn't matter. Bad joke. I'm a technical supervisor, not a supervising technician. Oh, instrument technician, that was my dad. That's my dad's job. But anyway, sorry. So we're here to talk about the Web Lab project. Web Lab is a series of five real-world Chrome experiments inside the British Science Museum in London. And we've, over the series, a couple of hangouts, we've basically been introducing each of the experiments. So today's is the teleporter experiment. And the teleporter is really cool. It's basically three teleporters, three kind of like periscopes inside the museum, essentially, which you can kind of move along and move around and kind of be transported across the world. I think we've got one in a shark tank in South Africa. So we've got a camera, 360-degree camera inside the shark tank. One in a miniature world in, where is it?
Hamburg.
In Hamburg. And then one in the bakery in just outside New York, I think, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 24-hour bakery.
Yeah, 24-hour bakery. It's pretty cool. The really cool thing I like about this experiment, it's very physical, even though everything about it is digital. But that's when you get online, you still get this very similar type of experience. So just kind of some of this, I took my son to the British Science Museum and we went on this, had a little play with it, took photos of where we were. I mean, he had no idea where the places were, but he was really, he was like, this is so cool. It's like, are they working in the bakery? It's like, yeah, they've just woken up. It was like 6 o'clock in the morning and there's like guys in the bakery kind of just like pounding dough and everything. It was pretty crazy. But anyway, let's jump into the experiment. So this is the main screen, kind of giving you kind of an introduction about what it looks like inside the museum. So these are the periscopes at least. I have a little theme for every single hangout that we've done. I talk about the loading screens, and this was Flash as well, was it? Originally Swift, Flash converted to us.
To a Swiffy.
To a Swiffy. So it's all in HTML5 and JavaScript, but via the Flash process. I get that in every time, because it's something I learned just from like this past week. It's pretty crazy. So this is the actual teleporter project on the website, which gives you pretty much the exact same experience that you get at the museum, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So we have the three cameras. We have this one here on the left, which is the deli. Hover over it. That's a pretty cool transition, wasn't it? This is the miniature world in Hamburg. And then this is the rather dark nighttime aquatic museum in South Africa, at least. I think we'll just go with the bakery one for most of this. Most of this hangout, it's got a lot of stuff happening. Oh, that was really cool. Did you see that drop off the screen then?
Yeah, this is pictures from other people.
That's the first time I've ever seen that. So basically what happens with the teleporter is that you can take snapshots at the museum or online as well, right?
Yeah.
And they get recorded to your lab tag, so when you go home you can kind of, you can get them back and see what you recorded and print it out. So should we just jump on this and kind of have a little kind of a brief technical deep dive into what people are seeing right now and why we've got donuts? I mean, are these real donuts? Well, not real donuts, but it's kind of crazy. So we have, should we start like a different way instead? Mm-hmm. Is that the, how to say this? There can be 10,000 people, 20,000 people at any one time controlling these cameras, right? So should we jump into one?
Yeah.
Cool,
and show what people what's happening. So this is the actual the museum. This is the bakery inside, just outside New York. Is it Amelie's mm-hmm. Bakery? Sounds cool. And as we can see that the camera is moving around, this is not the actual camera moving, is it?
No. So we have like a 360 camera on site, and then it sends the whole 360 panoramic view through a WebM live streaming.
Oh, it's a WebM live stream.
Yeah, so we don't use any plugin for this experiment.
Cool,
yeah.
So this is just like literally the video tag.
Yeah.
Mapped onto, presuming, is this WebGL, is it?
Yeah. So we received this video in the web of an HTML video, basically. Mm-hmm. It's like an infinite HTML video. And then we get this data, and we with a WebGL shader, we transform it and so you can.
So when you say transformers, you map it onto like the inside of a sphere or something.
It's or not actually a sphere. It's just a fragment shader that repositions each of the pixels.
Oh, so it's manipulating where the pixels are to make it look like it's kind of recombine this like weird shit.
To create the experience of the sphere.
That's kind of interesting. I always thought it was like the you mapped it onto like one texture you put onto the inside of a sphere and then you move the sphere around, but it's kind of even a little bit more meta than that. You use a fragment shader.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
See, so I was talking to Paul Lewis the other week about this, and I was calling them vertex. I swear they were called vertex shaders. Maybe it's DirectX or something. And he's like, no, Paul, they're fragment shaders. I was like, that's how much I know about WebGL just generally. So this is kind of scrolling around, but we do get the ability to kind of move it around ourselves, right, don't we? So we're not like a normal webcam from the 1990s where you would wait in a queue for a minute and a half to kind of like press up and then 2 seconds later it would move up. You get complete control of the webcam because it's entirely virtual, right?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Or the projection inside the screen is entirely virtual. It's a 360 degree camera. That's pretty cool. So I wonder what they're making now.
Brownies or something.
They look beautiful, looks sweet. Yeah, they look really nice. So if we wanted to, we could take a snapshot, right? Press the space bar, take a snapshot itself. So that's pretty cool. So this kind of compass in the background, I mean, is that like a, is that WebGL as well, or?
No, that's actually SVG that's generated in real time. So it's creating the tags as you turn around.
Oh, right. So it's not even already pre-created. It's not like a big, long screen.
No.
It's like creates the individual items and then positions the text. Oh, wow. Okay.
It's creating all in real time.
That's pretty cool. And how did you get this? Is this bend effect here? Is this part of the actual fragment shader?
No. The shader does much, but just that effect, we used the CSS mask.
Okay. So you're clipping off a region around that to kind of give it. That's pretty nice stuff, isn't it? Cool. And I have a silly question. This is going to sound stupid. So excuse me, everyone, if it is. This kind of like halo effect, is that just?
It's an SVG overlaying the whole thing.
Oh, right. So it's like you have like an opacity.
Yeah.
And then you kind of go to transparent to opaque.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Mm-hmm. So it's like we have someone looking through the window and he's waving hello. So these are, you know, this is how we record these things. It's pretty cool. Yeah. We go with the flow, see how it goes. What are some of the technical challenges that you faced with this project?
So I would say that the WebM live streaming was quite challenging on the back end. Because as far as we know, it's the first time that someone used this technology.
I don't think we've ever made any announcement or anything that we actually are streaming WebM video over the... we haven't... breaking news. This might get cut out. We don't know.
But obviously, with any mm-hmm. new technology, it's been quite challenging to handle all the errors and all the different.
That's kind of interesting because a lot of the time that we've done this, it's been a YouTube live stream. But I presume we couldn't pipe the data into like the 360 degree camera data into YouTube. And
no, it was not possible to get the data back.
Yeah. And I suppose the interesting thing is, actually, that's a really good point, is because that's the benefit of the HTML video stream, is that you can literally just put it into a texture and map it, put it through WebGL, which we couldn't do.
So the performance is much better. If we were using Flash, we had to send this data from Flash to JavaScript, which was slowing down a lot the whole process.
Wasn't there a very first early prototype where it was a Flash-based?
Yeah, at the beginning we were using Flash and sending the image data to the canvas.
Yeah, I'm really glad you guys got this working, actually, because it is beautiful. The thing I like about this project is you don't know about any of the technology it uses behind the scenes, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You don't know it's using WebGL and SVG and Canvas and all this type of stuff to kind of get this. It just looks pretty cool. I actually remember my son got a picture of a shark swimming past the front. He was like, he thought it was brilliant. Yes, but he thought it was amazing.
And we've seen people in the miniature Wonderland getting engineers coming up repairing stuff.
Really?
Kind of reaching for the camera.
Oh man, that's pretty cool. These are really cool, these ones. So just to jump onto this, well, we have no screen. So let me refresh. Oh, it was loading.
Did you
see that? It did say it was loading just as I refreshed. Hey, here's the I love these things. Right? Actually, so we're going to talk about the Universal Orchestra later on. I love some of the animations that you did in that one. So if you get a chance to watch the Universal Orchestra Hangout, I would do, because it's got some really cool stuff in there.
And we seem to have lost internet.
No, we haven't. So it's when you say we have lost it, we get it back. So this is a really cool thing. So, I mean, you mentioned something about canvas, normal 2D canvas.
Yes. So here we have both the WebGL showing the donut, which is actually just one shader that then transform it into the spherical view of it as well. So that's one shader. Yeah. And then around it, we have a 2D canvas that shows the clock.
Oh, so this clock around the outside here.
Yeah,
this is
the timer.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
That's pretty nice, man.
And when you roll over it, it's JavaScript moving divs and stuff to get
beautiful.
That animation.
That's really cool, isn't it? You know, I said this earlier on. I never saw the photos just drop off last time. Is that like a relatively new thing, or is that kind of been there?
It's been there from the start.
Yeah. Seriously?
Yeah.
Man, can I click on them?
No.
Feature request. So that's pretty cool, man. Watch the live stream.
And this is from the museum, which is closed at the moment.
That's pretty cool. We probably have to get special dispensation to get people through this. But this is like the museum, right? So these are the like you can see on the right, the orange teleporter and the blue on there. And it's exactly the same type of experience, right? Where you can take a photo, save it to your lab tag, and then kind of get it back later.
Yeah,
that's pretty nice. So that was a kind of a nice little deep dive into some of the bits behind kind of the teleporter project. Mm-hmm. It's one of my favorite ones. It's probably one of the most interactive ones there, like the physically interactive ones at the museum itself. If you get a chance, go and check it out in the museum. If not, check it out online. It's just a good, I can't speak. It's an awesome experience. Cool, thank you.